taking some chances now. Another strong shot by Perron is stopped by Rask. Here is Petrangelo. His shot went off Rask. Another shot. Oh, that one wouldn't go. Came on to the back of Gunnarsson, then on to play. That hopped off the stick of Petrangelo. Stick for Rask. Gotten by Bergeron, and he's able to lob it back down, and it will become an icing. They've gotten the stick back to Rask, courtesy of Chara.
Don't know if Tuukka Rask's pad was below his pad was below the goal line when he made the save, Doc. Now, does this puck completely cross the goal line? Boy, on that overhead look there, Doc, really quickly. This puck has to be completely over the line. And yes, that puck looks like it was in, Doc. Right there. Looks like, yep, right there against the pad.
Sure enough. This will give the crowd the first sign of life for the night. Here we go.
Upon further video review, the puck completely crossed the line. We have a goal.
This is Oshie. Oshie moving to his right. Behind the net. Wraparound attempt. They score! Capitals win in overtime.
Great. Totally agree.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, there it
okay,
is.
Now, on now,
that one,
okay,
that's different.
Now,
you blow
exactly.
That up.
Now the
blow
angle,
it up.
The angle is different from this area. So again, the stick is there. Is there white ice in between the puck and the goal line?
It certainly looks like there is.
Exactly. Again, from this angle.
Here comes Dan O'Rourke.
Upon further review, the call on the ice stands. We have a good goal.
Chopped on by Salavin. It is taken and swung to the net by Heatley. Another stop. Oh, reaching behind his Howard. Is it over the line? The Sharks are celebrating. No signal yet. No signal yet.
Healy just came by the bench. He said, that puck's definitely in, boys. We'll see.
Sure is.
It is. That
you see some white.
Up.
You see some white in between the puck and the goal line. It was the stick of Logan Couture. That's it.
That's a goal.
After further review, the puck crossed the goal line. We got a good goal.
By Camp, and Kunitz comes away, might have a two-on-one, has Hayden with him. Here's Kunitz driving, shooting, save, rebound, got to the line, and no goal is the call on the ice. Looked to me like it might have been in, but the play will continue. Now the Stars have iced it, so we'll be able to take another look.
Puck's got to go completely across the line, partner. I would agree with you. I thought it was some white. As that puck crossed the goal line, Chris Kunitz, he was right in behind the net, Pat. He almost had the best seat in the house. He's right behind the net, and it looks like that puck again. The angle where the camera is, that puck's got to be completely across the line. Can't, like there it looks like it's in right there. That looks like it is in, and it should be Chris Kunitz's goal, but again, the camera is not directly over.
Yes, the key there, and you pointed out the angle, as you could tell, the camera we're looking at there from high above, slightly off the goal line extended. You can see Danny O'Halloran, the call has been made. Let's take a listen.
After reviewing the play, the puck did in fact completely cross the goal line. We have a good goal.
Look at that reaction.
Have 8 shots on goal so far. Only 3 of them have come from forwards. 2 for Matt Martin, 1 for Clutterbuck, and there's one for Brock Nelson. Did it go? Ghislain Hébert looked like he wanted the signal goal, and if it didn't go in, it was awfully close.
Well, they'll be checking that one up on the video.
Referee right behind the net was about to signal no goal, then he changed his mind, and this is going to be a goal because they have blown the horn here in the middle of play, and that puck must have crossed the line.
The National Hockey League back in Toronto has had an opportunity to take a look at it, so while the game is going on, they take a quick look, and let's us take a quick look, Brendan, and see what we can see. The referee, as you mentioned, he started to raise his hand and then thought better of it.
He couldn't decide. As you watch right in front, Bailey, the drop pass for Nelson coming in.
Oh, gee, off the stick of Matheson. And
definitely crossed the line.
That's an interesting, take a little look from up above, and you'll see that puck goes. Yeah, that's good stop there by our crack crew as
after
far as watching the video.
It was determined that the puck completely crossed the line at 124.
It's not a good goal, but it's a good goal. The New York Islanders take a 1-0 lead. Credited to Brock Nelson.
Back over to Kessel. Shot one, and another one. Oh, and sliding across the Volpe. Rebound! It's near the line, but is it stopped? No signal of anything yet. There's a discussion among the two referees. And they will go and check.
And let's see this one. It careens off the post. Malkin right here. Does it go in? It's right there. I don't see it cross the line.
There's a lot of leather there trying to push it in. No sticks, but gloves and things. But I didn't see it cross the line at this point, certainly. The ring off the post, it's behind him. It doesn't go in right there. And it's tough to get a good handle on it.
Oh, we got to get another look at it because that's a bang bang play. But look where Brad Watson is. Perfect positioning by number 23, the official. You see where the blocker is? Is that stick on the line? You got to go back. Watch the stick. The stick's almost on the line. And look where the blocker is in the net. Look where the blocker is. It's in the net. What's the name of that view they called from the last game we did, Doc?
The parabolic? Parallax.
Parallax.
Now the fans here are seeing the parallax view. That's the one shot from outside of the net.
Miller again lets it go. Talbot the same. Oh, we cut it off. No. The signal is goal. Was on the doorstep. Did he get that puck across the line? Remember the last Bruins game? They weren't able to get it 100% across the line.
Well, let's have a look at it. Hard shot. Cam Talbot has it. Puck bouncing, bouncing, bouncing. Cam reaches back with the stick. Referee from where he is, you can see him, he's going to point right away. The overhead's going to give you the best look, as it usually does. Close, 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 close.
That puck went on edge, and that might be the difference.
Well, that one, well, from that angle, it looks like it did go over the line.
Eric Furlatt and Dan O'Rourke are the referees. And they are having a look.
That one doesn't look like it goes over the line. And from the overhead. Well, it certainly looks like most of the puck is over the line. Can you see this still? You can see part of that puck on the line, on the goal line.
Brad Marchand had a goal taken away in the game against New Jersey on Monday.
No challenge, a simple review, and we will get the verdict right now.
It's going to be a good goal.
It is a good goal, and the Bruins have tied it at one.
What they saw, which is Paco clearly over the line. Nice job on the feed right there. That's the camera that we don't have access to. Well, we have access to because we just showed it to you, but the NHL, that's the one they look at.
Back to the left point for Larkin. Out of the box, Hainsey. Shot through! Is it across? Bertuzzi says it is.
Oh,
they'll go to review here. The referee was not down at the goal line to see it. It looked like it eked across the line, but we'll have to wait and see.
Well, the
referee Furman South.
He didn't register no goal. He just went dead play, dead play, dead play. They're not supposed to assume, are they?
No, they're not. Well, we've seen that before,
yeah,
too, but no, they're not supposed to assume. And the referee, I mean, Furman South, what could you do? He was sort of blocked out by the glove,
right,
to tell.
Right. I mean, you see right there, right before he closes his glove on it, it looks like, right, that puck's in right there. That puck is in. That angle is from behind. And if that was right dead over the puck, it's in behind the line. Guaranteed that's in.
Now the whole puck's got to be over Mick.
You know, it is.
You know that, what I mean, that is, angle can be deceptive.
That's what I mean, is that angle is not directly over the goal line. It's from behind, you see?
Yep.
So it's showing the puck on the line there, so to speak, but they know it's not. There's no chance for that. This is too easy.
Referring with the situation room back in Toronto, so we'll get the call here from Furman South. It's in. So the Red Wings within a goal at 4-3 with 6-0.